Hi, I'm Peter Kuttenbrauer. This is the history of protectionism.
Protectionism is a word on many lips these days. Donald Trump wants to protect American jobs. One way to do that is to keep out stuff from other countries. Protectionism is an old idea. About 150 years before the birth of Christ, the Roman Senate passed a law which said nobody could grow grapes beyond the Alps. This ban protected Italy's grape growers. But by the first century AD, the Romans got thirsty, very thirsty. So the Roman senators changed the law. Rome began to import wine from the Iberian Peninsula, which today is Spain and Portugal, and from Gaul, which is now France. These regions had joined the Roman Empire. Several centuries later, in AD 476, the Roman Empire collapsed. Britain passed the Corn Laws in 1815. No corn could enter Britain until the local price reached 80 shillings per quarter hundredweight. It's like saying you can't import apples until apples cost $20 each. The Corn Laws helped British growers and British landowners, but these tariffs made bread so pricey that the public rebelled. Britain scrapped the law in 1848. From then on, Britain imported grain from its colonies, such as Canada. Britain was a good customer. Canada sent Britain our bacon, cheese, salt, fish, eggs, apples, furs, skins, leather, timber, and wood pulp. But Britain later chose free trade. We lost our best customer. Then the British Empire collapsed. Canada's first Prime Minister, Sir John A. Macdonald, the guy on the $10 bill, liked tariffs himself. Macdonald slapped import duties on cottons, woolens, furniture, and iron. He used the money to build a railway across Canada. Later on, Canada opted for free trade. In 1989, Canada signed the Free Trade Agreement with the United States. Effectively, we joined the American Empire. This deal worked well for us for a long time. Today, it seems America wants to walk away from its empire. The Emperor, Donald Trump, has no more use for colonies like Canada. The United States the other day slapped a 20% duty on lumber from Canada. Trump talks of a 20% tariff on stuff from Mexico, from avocados to automobiles. We risk to lose our biggest trading partner. Tariffs to protect American jobs may work for a while. In history, support for protectionism rises and falls. So do empires.